to Good Morning Sri Lanka. I hope you're having a wonderful morning so far, because we are definitely having a very inspiring and very intellectual morning today. And we still have Father Sylvester Ranasinghe, the director of St. Joseph's College, Colombo 10, with us right now.
Absolutely, you got it spot on, Anupama, when you said that you got a veteran in the field. Of course, Father, you are a veteran in the field of information and technology, and as we can see, it is an emerging theme in the context of the world. How do you relate it to your education system?
You know, the technology is developing very fast, you know, very fast, and then of course we have given the opportunities for the children to use the computers from grade 3.
Oh,
we have
okay.
3 computer labs,
okay.
105 computers, and then of course the boys start using them and then get the knowledge, and they are the teachers also use these technology and to in the classroom,
okay.
With the smart boards and PowerPoint presentations and all that. What I feel is, of course, we must allow the children to use this the development, because children are very talented, and my feeling is, of course, very near future, maybe within 1 or 2 years, A-level students should bring the computers to the college.
The laptops.
Laptops.
Wow.
And all that. Yes. That should
That's
happen.
Really interesting.
That should happen.
But the PowerPoint presentation, everything is done right now, is
right
it?
Right now, yes.
Okay.
Teachers and all that. And then, of course, whole college is connected with the fiber optics.
Oh,
and
right.
Then very soon it will be on Wi-Fi.
That's amazing. And I do you actually encourage PowerPoint presentations as such in class as well, Father?
Yes.
Okay.
Sometimes for the children, when they have to do some homework and all that, we allow them to have PowerPoint presentations. So
yeah.
They come and present, you know, sometimes 3 or 4 minutes.
Yes.
And the teachers are also using, and very interactive. And then, of course, the children are also very interested. You know, it's easy learning. You know?
Okay.
I think that's a good point, when we actually, you know, take a turn and a very big swipe from the conservative world,
yes,
of education,
yes, yes.
And move forward in the 21st century, yeah. Of education once again. I think it's a very bold move.
Yeah.
Did you feel a risk by any chance of doing this? Because I think a lot of schools, for that matter,
yeah.
Don't do this.
Yes.
Yeah, that's right, yes. And it's not easy, because we have to have so much of restriction, because
yes.
Today with this Facebook and everything, you know, used, misused.
Of course, definitely. Yes.
But otherwise, very powerful, very helpful communication media. So we are going to have all these restrictions with the passwords and all that, and firewalls and everything. So, but what I feel, we must allow the children to use.
Yeah.
That should be, you know.
That's a very open comment. I really like the fact that students are encouraged to do their homework as PowerPoint presentations, because they must be having, especially the younger ones, must be having a lot of fun doing that. And, you know, talking about the current education system, usually it's done starting in A-level classes or in university. But to know that it's in school, and, you know, I'm sure that the small ones are actually having a lot of fun.
Now I want to go back to school.
I know. Rather, you want to go back to St. Joseph's College.
Yes, I would. I've got a
yes.
choice. Maybe a time travel machine.
Okay, unfortunately, I can't be a member of that.
Yes. Father, talking about the 6th event that's
yes.
going to take place in a few days' time.
Yes.
Yeah. This is called the Rhythm of Joes.
Okay.
You know, and then, of course, we are having for the second time. Once again, the concept is, of course, allow the children to develop their talents. You know, last year we had art, photography, all that competition, and this year, every other year, we have this singing, dancing, and then instrumentalist, and then also comparing.
Wow.
How we start is also, once again, we give opportunity for every child.
Okay.
You know, as I told you earlier, of course, the primary students are given the opportunity to go on the stage, everyone.
Yes.
Then when they come to grade 6 upwards, they are given the opportunity to little more identify and polish their talents.
Mm.
So this is this way, of course, we start from the class level.
Mm.
The class will choose 3 students from each class.
Okay.
Then it will come to grade level.
Mm.
You know, then from there, junior, intermediate, and senior. So this is, of course, we have got the best talent.
Mm.
You know, this year, of course, what is very significant is this. You know, our children will participate and do everything, you know, even starting the IT, preparing these clips and all that, everything done by the children. And then also I must very sincerely thank the MTV and the NSLS also, so much of encouragement and help and support we get from here. And then of course even the instrumentalists will back our own singers and dancers this time. Yeah.
And you also mentioned comparing.
Comparing also, we started from class level, and it's once again it's a competition. It's a more than a competition, you know. But
showcase
we want
of talent.
Showcase of talents and give the best opportunity for the children to come up and they develop their talents. And then of course we hired all the children. Yeah. You are not going to be stars. Like serious star.
Yeah, so everybody wants to be a superstar.
No stars, but you are children. We are giving opportunity for you to identify their talents.
Yes, certainly.
You can develop and your talents whatever way you have. That is very important in a school. You know, to give opportunity, not just go to the class and study.
Father, like you, Father, like you mentioned before, you mentioned that. It's not just a competition, but it's overall a showcase of talent. But I just want the audience to know what kind of events and what kind of talent can we, the audience, expect on Saturday.
We have altogether 24 competitors, you know, coming on the stage singing, and Western Eastern mixture. And then of course singing, and then some of them will be singing on tracks.
Okay.
You know? And then also the instrumentalist.
All right.
You know, they are. And then also the comparing. Comparing, of course, they will do while the performance is on.
All right.
But those three, singing, dancing, and music, of course, they will perform on the stage.
And this is every single grade of the school?
Yes.
Okay.
Given the opportunity.
Okay.
And now we have come to the final stage, the best.
Right.
Okay, so anyone to watch this and witness this event, anyone can go and watch it, or?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes, that's right. Yes, anyone. You know, we encourage them to come and see this kind of a talent show, you know.
All right, shout out to you all watching Good Morning Sri Lanka right now. It's happening on the 6th
of this
month.
Yeah.
Is this a trilingual
yes, that's okay. Right, yes.
All
that
right.
Is also very important.
Yes,
and then because they can sing in any language they want. Either it's Sinhalese, Tamil, English, not any other language, of course. And I must say, too, last week we had the cultural day. Something different, but we have it, all these Sinhalese, Tamil and English, all these cultures come together, have one show.
Yes.
So then the children, the Sinhala children will know the Tamil culture and English, all that. And that's also a good show. Last Friday we had it on a grand scale. That is also very important today to, you know, study the culture and, you know, a lot of destroying the culture and all that, no respect and all that. But we must inculcate. We have a very rich culture, you know, whether it's Sinhalese, Tamil or English.
Okay, and now we have spoken about swimming competitions, the rhythm of the Joes on Saturday. I'm sure the Josephines are very excited for this period. What are the upcoming activities that everybody can expect from the Josephians in the recent future?
Now, after these the competitions and all that, of course, we have to concentrate mainly on studies.
Yes,
and because the exams are coming. But I must tell you also, we don't use very special school time mostly. Here and there, of course, we use it, but mainly after school and all that, these activities happen. And because we need to concentrate on education also. And then, of course, third term, of course, mainly we concentrate on studies because the last term of the year, and we don't have very many activities, you know. And for the whole year, everything is planned. Now we have the college diary and everything, and then of course the parents and children know what is going to happen. You know, we don't participate in all the tournaments and activities also outside now. Because
it's a chosen field.
What is important. And as you said, we have to balance everything. And
the audience might be wondering whether this is going to be an annual fixture, Father, or how is it going to work?
Rhythm of the shows. Yes. Every other year. Yes, that's right.
And you mentioned there's going to be art competition.
Yeah, in between.
Right.
Then of course, those who cannot, you know, those who cannot sing and dance, they can
draw
and or at least take a photograph. Even.
Yes, that's very interesting.
Talent, you know.
Yeah.
It is very important.
I was just wondering, actually, what is St. Joseph's College seem to be balancing of so many things, and I'm sure that, like you mentioned to us when we had a brief discussion before, Father, that the overall product of St. Joseph's College usually is good, and I'm sure that with all these details, the parents and the people are watching us obviously must be very inspired, and they might be encouraged. Because it's a vibrant place. It's a vibrant place to send your kids. It's a vibrant place to learn, study, dance, sing. But overall, what's your vision for St. Joseph's College?
Yeah. Now, when a child is admitted to a school, he's so raw, you know, so simple and all that. And then little by little, these 13 years, he goes through, you know, different activities, meeting teachers, all kinds of, you know. And then, of course, finally, grade 13, he is ready to go out. Mm. It's like, you know, machine, you put something, raw material, and it goes ups and downs, all mixtures and everything. Finally, you get the product, you know. And then, so that product is ready to go to the society. And like that, of course, what I want is, of course, the children to become good citizens of this country.
Definitely.
God-fearing and good citizens of this country who will be able to live a good life with the others, you know, properly related to the others, and then live peace and harmony. That is, I think, what is important, and then we have to stress here in school, you know, so giving so much of opportunities for the children.
Okay.
Of course, from the raw material to the finished product, as the father was saying, from the little kid who don't know about anything, right up to the adult who knows everything. Mm-hmm. And that's what we talk with Father Sylvester Ranasinghe. Thank you so much once again.
Thank you so much for making it.
It was intellectual, and of course we had a lot of thought as well throughout.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Yes, of course. We'll be back on Good Morning Sri Lanka with more, of course, more interviews and of course more intellectual thoughts right here. Stay with us.